Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm John, this is Media Truder, and welcome back to Starfield, where last time we came here to Mars. And okay, I'm going to be honest, I did not realize until I was editing the last episode that something rather important has gone missing, shall we say. And that's the crew. It turns out that yes, the entirety of last episode, my crew was missing, like all of it. None of the bastards are actually here, and yes, I think I know why. Because when everybody said they were going to go and help Vladimir deal with the eye, they actually, you know, meant it. Until I complete short-sighted, I literally don't have a companion, because my companions have abandoned me to go and do maintenance work on a giant space telescope. So, in which case, we should probably go and take care of that now. Oh, and hilariously, that's not the only thing being held hostage by this mission. Because apparently Vladimir now knows the location of a new temple. If he didn't, power from beyond wouldn't be in the journal.
My attention's glue is on the station monitors. Check with the others.
Basically, he's too busy doing the repairs too. So okay, the whole of Constellation has ground to a halt until we're done with this nonsense.
Just grab a wrench. Should be quick.
Here we go. I grab some wrenches. I tightened some equipment. There's a spark and... okay, I did just set something on fire with, like, my first attempt using the wrench.
You colored the wrong wires. Station showing red.
Yes, I will admit I may have just set something on fire. Like, how bad are we talking here?
Bad.
Okay, so, yes, this wasn't something I did. It was something that Sarah and me both did. All right, she was the one that told me to use the wrench, okay? Really, this is her fault.
Nastier than I measured. Figured a few of the parts might be iffy, but this is going to take more than a span.
Oh, I should have checked the compatibility when we made the order. I can stay with you until we get all this fixed.
No need for the martyr's clothes, but I'm happy to have the help. As for you, while we're giving the eye the sorts, need to tip your ear on another matter when you got the time.
Okay, so... right, so apparently that's the, yes, repairs done, as it turns out. Or at least, you know, as far as I'm concerned, and, I mean, I'm gonna be honest, that's fair. I showed up, I tried to help, I immediately set something on fire. Like, I wouldn't let me help any further either. That's reasonable. And that begins no sudden moves, and if we're lucky, we can also get ourselves, yes, a brand new temple as well.
Don't want to worry anyone, but we got more competition. Not Starborn. Rival collector. Captain Petrov owns a salvager vessel called the Scow. Runs it like a palace of novelties. And he's got a new prize in his collection.
Right, and if his whole thing is a gathering novelties, that means he probably won't sell at any price. Gotcha.
Reached out through my hand-to-hands to see if we can do an honest swap. He says the rock ain't for sale for any price. Think we're gonna need a crowbar and bag for this one.
Oh, flip me a heist, I cocking love it, though. Yes, indeed. Is he potentially refusing to sell it because he knows something about it? In fact, that's true. Maybe he was the first to touch it, he got the vision, and thus he knows it's something weird and alien and special.
He's got a reputation for seeing the gold in things, but he's no lab coat. Thinking he knows it's unique, but not why. All the more reason to clutch tightly.
Okay, maybe, maybe not, but... okay, I'm not a thief. I most definitely am a thief, alright? A heist sounds hilarious.
Left the life of a jack-up once behind myself. I know what I'm asking. But I see a clutch prize not up for the prying any other way. Not sending you lone hook on the job. I want Sam with you on this one. You two will be foot to foot the whole way, so make sure you're ready.
Okay, so yeah, Sam used to do some slightly dodgy crime, we know that's certainly true, so go on then, let's lock him in for now. Alright, job done, Sam Coe's my active companion, magnificent, though before we set off in that direction... here we go, he's speaking to me again, so yes indeed, buddy. Put another temple on my star map, please. Here we go, she's in an old friend too, so Tau Ceti, where the whole UC Vanguard business began. Apparently, there's a temple over on Tau Ceti 3, lovely. Oh, hello, hang on. Maybe there is actually a problem, actually, because, oh, there's a lot of red suddenly on the mat, though. It would appear to be slightly damaged. Hang the cock on. Oh, this is level 20 nasty stuff, actually. Okay, this is bad. Hang on. We've got maybe some trouble here, actually. There's high-level space hyenas and whatnot. Just take you guys out, please. There we go. You guys need to start going down. Come on, lock on. Anytime you're cocking ready. There we go. Now my missiles can take you out, though. Right, okay. These guys are a bit on the nasty side, but also a bit on the damaged side. And we've got a lot of cocky rocks in the way, actually. Hang about. Luckily, I've got a cocking lot of, yes, big, beautiful shields. And, oh, blimey, we just sort of rammed you. Sorry about that. We're both quite big these days. Just get right up in front of you, ram you a little bit.
Reached our collective owes you, stranger. Please acknowledge.
Okay, apparently we had assistance this entire time. I wasn't aware of that, but apparently, John, that's a meteorite. That's not a ship. It is weird, though, how, yes, the reward you get from, like, you know, helping people is always so vastly less than what you get from just scavenging the corpses. Like, 5 grand a go. That is not bad. And, yeah, I feel like next time we see them, hyenas might always be maybe B-types or something. Because those guys were big, but also slow. So I suspect, yes, they were slightly bigger, heavier ships. Lots of shielding and whatnot. But, crucially, they did, you know, reveal a slight issue I've got inside my vessel, which is not good at taking apart hull once the shields are down. My lasers can deal with the shields, but then we have problems. So, okay, we may need to change out the weapon load at some point or another. Okay, down onto the planet. A nice, easy one on this occasion. The temple is literally in sight from our landing site. So, all right, let's see what we've got today. Oh, hang on. The image. It had colors in the middle of it. Okay, we've got ourselves. Hang on, we've got trouble. We've definitely got trouble. Sam, chill out for a second. We've got trouble right now. And hello over there. No. There we go. Nice and exploded. And it would appear we've got ourselves a reactive shield. So, okay, for about half my mana pool, I can make a shield of a pure cosmic light that can weaken and maybe even reflect enemy projectiles. So, okay. I'm gonna be honest, that really depends on, like, how often we're reflecting versus weakening. Weakening sounds not interesting. Reflecting sounds hilarious. So, alright, crank this open just to, like, you know, give it a test. And okay, it follows me around. It's not like, you know, a wall I'm putting up in a particular position. And how long does it last? I mean, quite a long time, really, so bare minimum, if I run into, like, you know, a super tough enemy, that's going to give me a lot more survivability. So, you know, say a random level 50 raider who absolutely annihilates me. Sometimes you do run into that sort of thing, so could be useful just in terms of staying alive while my shotgun does its job. Okay, and now I'm back on the ship. Yeah, something I did realize that's rather bloody useful in terms of, you know, not blowing myself up with my highly explosive shotgun, with which I do often blow myself up. Which is due to the weird quirk that, yes, helmet mods become unlocked at one level lower than spacesuit mods. I can't put explosive shielding on my armor, but I can put it onto my helmet, or rather I could if I hadn't already burnt all my titanium. And also I need one sterile nanotube, which is a thing I don't know how to make. So, okay, next time we're back in civilization, we can do some shopping, so I've got at least some protection against my own shotgun. Oh, and that does remind me, I've got a cocking level up, and okay, this one, I think I know what we're doing, okay? We finally completed our previous main character objective, get up to special projects, and bloody hell was that worth it. So now I am an unstoppable god of explosions on the ground. It's time to become an unstoppable god of explosions in space too. So I would say, right, class B, let's cocking go. Because yes, if I understand this right, I need to go over to a type B reactor. That's what determines what the ship is. That's why the A is written next to the reactor on the Star Flamingo. So yeah, if I get a type B reactor, then at that point, anything else that's type B, I can plug onto my ship. So even the very best type A weapons might be inferior to just a mid-range type B. We'll have to see next time we're passing by a shipyard. For the time being, though, okay. All existing plans go out of the window, because the game has said to me I could do a heist, and I feel like my character is very well set up to do a heist. Like, sense star stuff, that is just heist material, unless your ship is guarded by robots, in which case this is going to be a messy heist. Okay, we're going to Procyon by the looks of it, and yes, I've definitely been here before. Pretty low level, nothing too dangerous, and let's see what we've got. But okay, John, before you jump over there, okay, this is a heist. We're going to be doing this all properly. After all, it might not just be about, you know, a stealth on the ground, it might also be about stealth in space. We need to basically power down everything, including our shields and our engines, alright? Power down literally everything as low as it can go so that we can still, you know, move and jump. But everything else, we're keeping in the reactor, okay? So, okay. Begin jumping. The calculations will take me a few seconds because I'm barely powering the... No! Why did the grav drive power up? I did not ask for the grav driver to be powered up. I wanted it to be low power. There we go. That's better. Okay. Debris fields. I've come in, like, you know, a little bit closer than I'd like, to be honest. Pretty big ship, all things considered. About 1,000 away. I mean, in theory, it's only level 10. If we just explode it, we could just get, like, you know, the stuff out of the wreckage. Okay. Now, maybe, should we, like, you know, just mosey up to them and try and dock with them? Without them realizing. This feels like it's not gonna fly. Like, surely they would notice another ship docking with them. Here we go. I've got to either talk my way on or open fire and disable the engines in order to board by force. So, I mean, just out of interest, could my stupid plan of just sneaking up behind them by drifting in with basically no power in my system potentially work? Like, if I get within 500 meters of them, am I allowed to just basically begin, like, you know, docking procedures? I mean, theoretically, it might work. Like, incredibly dumb space stealthiness, and... No. No, we can't. Right, well, in which case, well, no reason to, like, you know, be hidden. Power up the shield, if you'd be so kind. Power up, you know, basically everything. But especially the weapons. Bear in mind, I am especially good at disabling ships. Alright, that's something I am very, very good at. We could take the ship apart in seconds, should it be necessary. But let's not make that plan A. Okay? Plan A, talk our way on board. Get in, Suitoni Silent Assassin. Right, one quick Chardonnay, just to, you know, get things moving in the right direction. And put on a nice jacket too. We can put on the, like, you know, reloading jacket down the line if need be.
You don't have business with this gal. Our captain is not taking visitors.
Alright, so, funny old thing about that, and, ooh. Right, we could let Samco do this, and, honestly, that feels good. Like, that feels like the right bait to get them to let us aboard.
Oh, I think Petrov will want to talk to us. We're from Constellation. Got a lot of one-of-a-kind pieces from all over the settled systems for sale.
Really? You're willing to sell? I thought you Constellation types only took things.
Hey, we all need to make a little side money, am I right? Let us aboard and your boss can have his pick. For the right price.
I think that will be acceptable, giving you permission to dock.
Right, so there has to be, like, you know, docking procedures or whatnot. You've got to give me permission, otherwise, yeah, I need to knock out your engines for a hostile boarding. So, okay. Let's go aboard. Let's make this happen nice and easy. Okay, so we are now officially aboard. We've also got ourselves some lovely bits and pieces here. Need to find the captain. Honestly, I kind of don't want to find the captain. I'd rather, like, you know, mosey round and find the artifact without ever causing trouble, though... Okay. Your ship is a bit of a mess. To be honest, like, this is not a good first impression. We can also scout out how many people are here, so... Right, loads of heat leeches down below, suggesting maybe, like, you know, a ventilation tunnel or something. At least three people nearby.
Who let you on board? Thought Petrov was done hiring mosquitoes. Or maybe you're after something from the captain's collection.
Okay, Tau, chill. Me and you, we're gonna be friends. Okay, Special Rock, let's maybe me and you work out a deal. Like, he might not sell, but maybe this guy could be open to a bribe.
Oh yes, The Rock. He's not selling it. But if you want to hear him laugh in your face personally, go right ahead.
You might find we can be really persuasive about rocks. We just love rocks.
And before you ask, Petrov's the only one with the keys, so don't try bribing any of the crew. You'll just waste your money.
Okay, so a bit of pickpocketing might be necessary to get the keys, and yes, where did he get it from?
Traded for it. Some dusty hauling ore from the fringe. Was glad when he left. It's all shakes and muttering.
Okay. He's touched it. He's seen the vision. No wonder he doesn't want to sell.
Petrov's got a whole little alien zoo in the back. He's asking for trouble with those things. But the locks on the cages are pretty high end. Thankfully.
Okay, now that's rather useful information. Thank you for letting me know about his pet pteromorph or whatnot. So okay, let's just make sure we understand who's where. So we got ourselves, oh dear, various locked doors. Can't do anything with them, but I'm not seeing, anything else or anybody else about by the looks of it.
Welcome to Petrov's Palace of Peculiarities, the pinnacle of perfect procurement, the penultimate panopticon of prosperity.
Okay, I think we've entered the bit of the ship where, yes, he actually wants visitors. In sort of a weird way. It's nowhere near as nice as that lovely ship we found when we were doing the Freestar business, but... Okay. He's like, you know, put a bit of carpet out at the bare minimum. Right. Keep on keeping on. We've got security storage, security office. Lovely. May as well just... Actually, you know what? Don't steal food. They might get upset if you start stealing some food. That's an expert lock to get into a security office, which we might need here for, yes, we want to maybe, I don't know, open up that zoo that was just mentioned. I'll tell you what, though, I do rather enjoy, you know, just trinkets for my own ship, so... Okay, just lights off. Help myself to one cool mask thingy. I'll be having that at the bare minimum, so okay... Even if we have to murder everybody else, I do at least have a rather nice cool thing to put on, you know, my new ship's cockpit. So, oh my goodness, you're just sitting lounging on a chaise long. I love it. Okay, but maybe more of interest up here in this room. Yeah, we've got people who aren't just, you know, guards. You've got names and whatnot.
Well, gentlemen, we have a newcomer. Place your bets.
I'll go with buying. 100 credits says they leave with one of the captain's glorious golden statues.
You know those are colored aluminum, right? I say selling, but nothing the captain wants. You win, Bull?
Yeah. Count me in. I say selling. A cargo hold of all the oil paintings. All fakes.
Bold. I like it.
Okay, so they're betting on a yes, what I'm here to do, so... Right, do you guys, like, you know, work for Petrov, or do you, like, you know, bring and sell him stuff?
Us? We're in, acquisitions.
She means we hunt things down and steal them.
From bad people. Mostly.
A lot of these old relics the captain collects don't have legitimate owners, so it's sort of right by possession, you know? And, we help with the possession part.
I'm gonna be honest, I kinda don't want to, like, you know, release monsters to kill everyone on this ship. Like, I feel like me and Petrov are kinda kindred spirits. He wants to have a giant ship full of gaudy trash. And that's all I want, really. Like, me and him understand each other. So, yes. The unusual rock, I'm guessing it's in that special vault that was mentioned.
Oh no! Looks like we all lose.
Including you, newcomer. The captain's obsessed with that damn rock. Got it in the vault and everything.
You know, I hear that vault got made on the cheap.
Quiet! Quiet! No spilling the captain's secrets.
At least not for free.
Okay. 1,000 credits and I get some good information and... Okay, before we get to that, yes, tell me about the captain.
I mean, look around, you know? This ship kinda says it all.
He's a self-obsessed megalomaniac with delusions of grandeur.
I don't think that's fair. He's just eccentric, like a best friend who's great in really, really small doses.
One thing he's good for is steady pay. He knows how to spread the wealth around.
You know what? I like these guys. I like Petrov. You're getting paid. Here's 1,000 credits. That is nothing to me.
Oh, we would never do that. We love our captain.
We love his money.
Oh, yeah. Right. Hand over the credits, then. Let's talk.
I hear the back end of the vault butts up against the old conveyor belt system.
Crew says those walls were just meant as partitions. They're thin, held up by a few old security bolts. A laser could just cut right through them.
Not that you would, being a respectful guest of this ship and all.
Okay, so... yeah, I know precisely what they're talking about. Those cut-downable bolts. Okay. I think that's good enough information, to be honest. Though, okay, you know what? I like you guys, you get paid. Tell me more.
You hear about the zoo? Captain went through a phase, and now there's a whole mess of alien wildlife in cages below deck.
They don't look happy there at all.
They're in cages. Why would they be happy? And how can you tell? They're aliens.
I don't know. They just... seem sad when I look at them.
Anyway, the technician for the cages quit recently, and I have it on good authority that the password is now Idiot Captain. Worth a chuckle if you want to try it.
But don't, because those aliens might kill everyone.
Okay, so... ooh, I could even bribe them to back me up if a fight breaks out. But no, 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 we're not doing that. Just back out of this. Okay, so in theory, we've got to figure out, yes, how to find the thin walls. Looks like, yes, the vault is over in this direction. No need to bother Petrov just for the moment. Okay, the trick's going to be figuring out, yes, how we get deeper into the ship, given, as we've just established, I can't get past most of the doors. So, okay, bare minimum, over in this direction. We do have one door I can crack. You, sir, are advanced, not experts, okay? Just to very quickly sort out you. Here we go. Nice and easy on this occasion. In. Now, why is this area... okay, this area is locked down because it lets me get down to the lower decks. And officially... gonna be honest, I'm not sure if I'm trespassing. No, I'm not. Because if I was, then yes, the hidden would be going, yes, orange, to indicate that I would be in trouble were I to get spotted here. So, okay. Help myself to some nice money. Just of interest, what does this switch do? Oh! Okay, did not realize this was, like, you know, an openable door or anything. So, okay, this presumably leads down to... oh, yeah. Lower deck. They did say the zoo's on the lower deck, so... right. Right here, we've got zoo control, which I'm guessing would be locked down, but I've got the password. So we got ourselves one lovely monster here. The door, yeah, literally can't be opened without the computer. I'm guessing the computer would normally be... oh dear. Right, so certain people have been eaten by the monsters at various points, and I'm gonna be honest, I feel like this one isn't inside its cage. So... oh, Bethesda games never change. Right, so option one. Simply release the creatures and run. Okay, and as for the room I can drop down into, thanks to the advanced locked door, that's just an alternative solution to the cells, and arguably a better one. Because, yeah, in this case, I'm not in the room where, you know, the creatures are being released. So they'll just come out, start eating everybody, etc., etc. So, right. This here, this is the terminal down from the advanced locks room that we definitely want to use if it comes down to let's just make everybody on the ship get eaten. And as for, yes, getting to the thin walls over here, they are just around the corner from the cells, but if you get close to these guys, right, they actually go red, meaning I'm not supposed to be here. Right, if I get seen in that area, they're going to attack. That's just... oh, hang on. Hang on. Gosh darn it, it's an instigating firearm, but honestly, 69 doubled up to 138. Even then, it's just not that exciting, though. I will steal it just to sell, that's true. Right, I've just dropped a save just to check if that's true. So yeah, if I go into this room, do you guys get angry at me? All right. You're definitely angry. If I just run straight past you... yeah, okay, fine. So if you get seen by those guys, they will open fire. Gotcha, that's what the rep means. So don't worry about that, Sam. We're not doing this. I was just checking. Alternative universe, no trouble, etc., etc. So, right. Do not go into that room. I need to find alternative ways around. I mean, option three, which I really feel like, you know, maybe I should have checked out earlier, is I could just speak to Petrov. Like, maybe... I can sweet-talk him.
Ah, I wasn't aware we had the visitors. Vadik, you didn't tell me we had visitors.
We have visitors.
Excellent. Now that you've gone to all this trouble to get here, you should make yourself at home. Relax. Kick up your feet on the tables. I don't care they have scorch marks on them anyway.
I'm going to be honest. My, you know, preference towards murdering everybody did just go up a bit based on the fact that I really love what he's wearing. Like, sometimes when you see unique gear, it's not on the corpses when you go to collect. Like, this is a risk here, but bare minimum. Let's butter this guy up a bit. Before we murder him, let's see if maybe we can sweet talk him.
Oh, flattery, huh? My favorite pastime, huh? Between you and me, I do have something very special in the vault. Ah, but my jealous heart knows no bounds. I want to keep it all to myself.
Yes, indeed, buddy. How about just a small peek? That's all I want, though. Right, before we do that, make sure... actually, you know what? No. I'm already wearing the jacket. We should be okay.
Tempting. I do love showing off. But my security team will have a heart attack. It would be against all those protocols that I admittedly told them to make.
Okay, so... not that difficult, all things considered. Three turns only to get to six, so... yes, indeed, buddy. I get it. Your collection is small. You're embarrassed. It's understandable.
Now. No need to be insulting.
All right. Good approach. And yes, indeed, Petrov. What's the point of a vast, beautiful, amazing collection if there's nobody to appreciate it?
Oh-ho! You do have a point. Very well. What's a quick look going to hurt, huh? I know. People look at me and say, Petrov, your whole ship is a testament of splendor. Why do you need a special vault? Well, all I can say is that even the greatest collection needs its own private viewing area. Plus, between you and me, there are thieves everywhere. So I spared no expense. Every door between me and my treasures is painful, but that is the price of security, eh? Que sera? Just a bit further. This ship and I have been through some adventures, I'll tell you. I once collected salvage from a Deimos Celestial class while it was exploding. The crew was scraping scorch marks and bits of metal off the hull for weeks. And of course, there was the time I accidentally steered us into a UC Navy vessel after a particularly uproarious celebration of my latest acquisitions of fine art. But we were wedged perfectly between their two thrusters and were able to just kind of push them back into the Star Yard for repairs.
All right, in we go. Nice. The question is now, do we need to... Oh, blimey, you've got more people here yet, though. Right. And, ooh... You've got other treasures here. Now this I like.
And now, the moment itself. Ah, beautiful, isn't it? The man who sold me this told me that it spoke to him. That holding it for the first time was like drowning in your own soul. Alas, I've held it several times, and my soul is still breathing, devoid of any such enlightenment.
Okay, so, yes indeed. The previous owner, he was the one who touched it and got the vision. Don't mention the power, by the way, that'll just make him want it more. So, yes indeed. By any chance, did he mention Bedrock?
Why, yes, he did.
So, okay. I'm guessing you are not selling for any price.
Oh, no. No. I can't. This one is mine. And it's only fair to warn you. Hands off! I would hate to sour our new friendship by becoming the victim of piracy.
Hey, we're not pirates. Except, well, when we really need something for really, really good reasons. Yeah, that does sound a little piratey, doesn't it?
Okay, so we could grab it, or... Right, any chance of a deal that could be done, Petrov? Like something else you want instead?
I'm afraid not. I'm easy in all things, except my collection.
Okay, so... I feel like I just want to back out this conversation for just a second, because if nothing else... I'm curious what else you've got. So, oh my goodness, old world computers, various bits and pieces, lovely. You've got yourself a nice mannequins here, etc, etc. Just, I mean, that's just money. That's a bit on the boring side. Advanced bits and pieces too. Okay, not bad, not bad at all. Right. What else have we got here? And are you just going to, right, you're just going to stand here. Want to have a bit of a looksy roundy. Okay, tragically, he's not moving, and I suspect he asked, because I didn't have the security to break in the back way. That means we can't just steal it, then be on our way. So, right. We're going to try and minimize casualties, and the way we're going to do that is, one, we unlock this door. All right. And then, two, we're going to take out the locals right here. Then, whatever's behind this door... We'll use that to try and escape without having to fight, you know, literally everybody. So, okay. Bare minimum. Straight behind you, buddy. Can't even pickpocket you, which is fascinating. But, I'm sorry, Petrov. I didn't want it to come to this. But actually, I'm going to be honest, I kind of did. I did want you to die. Because I do want to, like, you know, have your spacesuit. If it's even vaguely possible. Bare minimum, we're going to try and do this quick, calm, and quiet. So, yeah. Silence McJibble. You, buddy. Go down nice and quick. You're dead, I believe. And you go down too.
Wait!
I surrender! I surrender! Don't kill me!
I'm going to be honest, I was sort of planning to kill you for your stuff, but... Right. If your crew stand down, maybe we can stay friends, alright? I like you, Petrov. I don't want to kill you.
We're only doing what we have to.
Done! Stand down, everyone. Let the nice pirate pass.
Alright, I've got the vault key. I've got artifact 5. And with that, we can leave. So, I'm really sorry, by the way. You didn't need to die. That was bad of me. Also, you know what? Let's just, you know, while we're passing by, just check what's going on through this lovely back area. I feel like, you know, I don't want to walk back through the public area at this point. Like, I feel like, you know, they're gonna mind. And also, it's a cocky microsecond regulator there. Well, that's bloody convenient. The exact moment I don't need it, so... Right. The secret backstage area. That's how to get into, the vault the proper way. Right there. Help myself to all of this noise. Question is, yes, how did I get into this without causing trouble with Petrov at all? Because I feel bad about what we've done to Petrov today. So, yeah, we got one guard up here. If we go out this way, hang on, this brings me to... Okay, there was an entire, backstage area that I did not realize was here, though. Ooh. Okay. Potentially got ourselves a 5 grand and... resource hauler and technician. No, I'll leave that be. Like, I just can't give up my... Ooh, blimey. Well, that's valuable at least. Okay, so the door to this area was, behind a broken thing. I'm guessing maybe there would have been a way to... Yeah, there must have been a way to break into this area. What was the intended, you know, sneaky stealthy route that I failed to find? I genuinely don't know. Like, I'm not sure how you get into this area without having, you know, already been in this area because the captain walked you into this area. I cannot see a way in. So, okay, this dungeon's got me stumped, but for the time being, probably best we leave before, anyone else decides to start shooting me. Okay, here's interesting, mind, which is, I've now got a bounty of 500 credits in the UC. Is it because... Well, I suppose I did just do a heist on... Hang on. Are you... Oh. Are you guys technically UC citizens? Okay, I guess I was, like, you know, very publicly seen stealing somebody else's property. And, like, we are pretty close to UC space and whatnot, so... Right. I guess someone called the cocking space cops on me. Okay, that's fine. We can fix that. I've got, like, you know, a bounty payoff bawdy McJibble in my house over in Olympus, so we can sort this out. No trouble. You know, thinking about it, maybe it was the murder. I did murder a man. That's true as well. Also, while I'm here, way more importantly, I'm putting up some space frog posters. All right, we're putting up space frog posters in my room here, because Space Frog is the best frog. So we'll just put up you, then one of you as well. There's Space Frog hugging a star because he's amazing, hanging out in space, doing his own thing. And finally, right above the bed, the best one of all, Space Frog, just, you know, on a planet, looking happy. Oh, now that's much better. And while I'm up here, I've, neatened up my room a bit. So, okay, we need to find a lot of decorations to put on the various built-in storage solutions. But for the time being, we've now got, like, you know, a nice sitting area, some lovely plants. We've got, you know, the Space Frog posters. All my cuddly toys are still here, right on the bed. Made a small work corner. So, you know, got computer, desk, science stuff going on the whiteboard over there, which is lovely. And I've put up a room divider, so if I get raided by the feds, they won't see my contraband chest. Also, do not forget, John, you're supposed to be, clearing the bounty from the murder that you did. Because now I'm allowed back on Jemison without anybody shooting me. Better and better. And would you believe it, because we've got a new artifact, that means Vladimir's got a new temple. That's definitely how it works. So, right, toss this into the pile. Let's see what that does.
Vladimir! Vlad, come in! come in! The eye's gone completely dark. I can't reach anyone on the station.
Oh. I'm gonna be honest, Noella. Last time I was there, I did kinda start a small fire. But, like, that fire can't have got that big, right? I'm sure it's fine.
Noelle, Starborn, came out of nowhere.
Vladimir, get out of there!
He already left. Said he was going to the lodge.
Uh-oh. Okay, I'm gonna be honest. That's where I am right now. So that's a problem, because there's literally a small child. Small child, go and hide in a cupboard or something. The grown-ups need to do some murder now. Also, the rest of my cooking crew's up there. Are the rest of my crew okay?
Sarah, she's still breathing, but oh god, all that blood!
Hello, Constellation. Are you there?
Who are you? What did you do to our friends?
They call me the Hunter. And now that I'm here, your part in glimpsing the Unity is over.
Okay, so... Right. The Unity. You're giving away important secrets right now, buddy.
I'm already on my way. Say goodbye to your friends. It won't be long.
Forget about us! That Starborn bastard is after the artifacts! You can't let him take them! Pack up the collection, move it somewhere they can't find it!
He's right. We need to bunker down here and get those artifacts ready to move. Might need every gun to hold that Starborn off.
What about everyone on the Eye? We can't leave them to die up there.
Oh, uh-oh, right, Oh, that's tricky, Okay, feels like this guy kills people. Like, if I leave, these people are in trouble. If I stay, the people in the Eye are in trouble. Oh dear, right. Okay, I don't know precisely how high the stakes are right now, but this is Constellation. These are Constellation people in danger on the Eye. And they specifically said to us, we want you to protect the artifacts. So, okay. We're going to do that. We're going to stay here. We're going to protect the artifacts. We're going to get to the Eye later. Because the people on the Eye, that's what they told us to do.
Watch each other's backs. We're not losing anyone else today.
I don't know how long it's going to take to pack up the artifacts. I'll get started. Hopefully this will only take a few minutes, if my hands can stop shaking.
Uh-oh, Walter. All right, go. And hello there. And, oh, he's immediately decided to, okay, John. I was kind of thinking we might, you know, be able to talk to this guy. Apparently not, right. We'd love some Aurora right now, but screw it. Blend's gonna have to do. Blend will be fine, all right? Drink the blend. You, buddy, you are going down, down, and, oh, blimey, hang on, there are multiple hunters here. There are, also, he appears to be not really taking damage, which is, oh, possibly some of these people are fake. Oh, and they are hitting really cooking. Right. It's time to break out the good stuff, John. Time to break out the really, really good stuff, all right? Emergency kit. This is definitely an emergency. That's fair. Next up, Panopticon. Go. All right, we're breaking out the real good stuff here. And more blends too. Shame we don't have proper Aurora. I did not realize we were walking into this much trouble today. So, okay. Reload. Reload faster, actually. I'm under, like, you know, a time limit here. And no. No, this is... Are you even real? I don't know which one of these is real. They're barely taking any cocky damage. Okay, toss explosives. Go. This is not doing anything. Hang on. This is... Right. I think we should just go. Because I feel like we're not doing anything right now. Noelle, cooking, run. Yep, I'm pretty sure they're invincible. Small child, stay here and, like, you know, guard our backs. Everything's going to be fine. I say this. Okay, everyone appears to be... No, that's Vasco. Vasco's here. We've also got one One nasty one coming in. He appears to have fallen behind, so that's absolutely fine. Close the door. Maybe he'll struggle with doors. Oh, we're finally using the secret back door. I knew this would be used for something at some point. All right, keep on keeping on. We're just going to make a run for the ship here. Hopefully someone's remembered to bring, like, you know, the key, by the way. Because last time I checked this place out, we did not have a key. Looks calmer to me. I'm not seeing any more trouble. So, yeah, just book it for the exit. We're going in the well, people. Lovely. This door's now just open. We good? We appear to be good. That's a vast go, so that's all a-okay. And now, oh, hello, hi. Honestly, should we even fight right now? I'm not sure we should fight. I think we should just go. I think we should just go, and it's all going to be, like, fine. Noelle's the important one. She's got the artifacts. I mean, let UC Security take care of this. It's all going to be fine, probably. I feel like, yes, we can't do anything. Noelle, please just, you know, pathfind better at the moment because, oh, bloody hell, the crowds are getting in the way. This is amazing. I literally can't get past the Bethesda crowds. Guys, you protect me, okay? That's your job right now. Lovely. Let's just get into the cock me. The Bethesda crowds are getting in the way. Just get to the spaceport. We're going. Everyone seems to be alive for now, but seriously, I'm not sure there's nothing we could do. Even a crit to the head is doing nothing to him. We're just running right now. For the time being, we are powerless against him. Just spam the med packs and run. There's nothing we can cocky do. Just, if I get back to the ship before everybody else, I can, yeah, trigger the load zone and they'll probably just teleport to meet with me. Everything's fine. I start sprinting again. A wild boost pack comes back. Then we just get into cockpit space. All right, cockpit, go. Hopefully that'll be John. They've got spaceships. Super advanced. Is everyone on board? Okay, everyone's on board. To the eye. Let's cock it, go. In fact, you know what? Bare minimum. Oh, cock me. That's the Scorpius.
What are you going to do with the armillary now? I wonder.
I mean, bare minimum. We've got a good ship. And we're also surrounded by friends. Like, right now, I am cocking surrounded by other UC ships. I mean, they would back me up, right? Really hope they back me up. Okay, first things first. Yes, artillery or whatever you just said. Okay, so he doesn't want to talk much. Basically, screw you. I've decided this time we're standing and fighting.
Oh, please. Don't you have some friends you need to check on? There's a greater purpose to all this. You might have a larger role than I realized. Mistake on my part. Keep collecting the artifacts. We'll meet again. Maybe you'll boost the unity yet.
Ooh. Well, he suddenly changed his tune and immediately decided to naff off. Damn, I feel like, yeah, with all this backup, we'd have stood a chance. Right, fast as you like, team, let's get back to the eye because, yeah, I'm slightly concerned. There was a lot of mention of, you know, Sarah bleeding a lot. Hail the eye. Oh, no response isn't good. All right, on board. Last time we saw Sarah, she was right at the front with the wrenches. Sarah? Oh, that's not looking good. Okay, so... Oh. Apparently, yes, as a medical person, if you know medicine, it's even cocking worse.
Hey, Sarah. Sarah, can you hear me? It's Sam.
Oh, dear. Sam, I get it. I too am vibrating in grief right now. Sam, you're seriously undermining this moment at the minute. Okay, it would appear I may have made a bad decision. Oh. I feel like, there we go! He's managed to figure his way into the position he was supposed to be in. I'm guessing he was trying to, you know, vibrate into that position before. Good job, Sam. Right. I'm guessing in this mission, somebody dies, either someone in the lodge or someone up here. And I know it's harsh to point this out, but at least it was the person whose, yes, loyalty mission we'd already done. So we're not missing out any loyalty missions. We've already seen hers. I'm sorry, Sarah. You were, you know, nice and useful. You were a good navigator. Now I need to find a new bloody navigator. But yes, I suspect there's nothing we can do. I'm sorry, Sarah.
We're gonna finish this thing for you, okay? Sarah, we'll solve this mystery, I swear. She's gone. Come on. Let's get going. There's no changing anything now.
Alright. So, Sam's hanging out with me, at least for the time being. Vladimir. Is Vladimir okay? Okay, you look better, because I need you to tell me where temples are.
You're alive. Krix's ghost can keep waiting.
Okay, so I'm guessing the hunter just sort of appeared. That seems to be a thing he can do.
Saw the ship dock with the eye. We took up the arms call, but when the doors opened, there was no one there. Skulked in like a damn specter. Before I had to know, it was nothing but pain's wings and a cold sleep. Time's unknown, but I came too long enough to hear him gloat about going to the lodge and seeing our friends trying to crawl away from him on a bloody trail.
Okay, now that's interesting. That suggests these aren't just like, you know, mega advanced super aliens who could just teleport anywhere they want in the galaxy. He still had to dock his ship before he could start teleporting, suggesting the teleport might actually be a bit short range. Right, we're learning here. This is good. And yes, more Starborn, I'm guessing, because I definitely saw at least two.
Not many sights to see before I lost the lights.
Okay, he doesn't know, and I'm guessing the eye's still not in good shape either.
Can't be sure yet. Starborn could have done a lot more damage. Guessing the glitter of the prize wasn't here.
Yeah, he was after the artifacts.
No tears for the old. Got the others to worry about.
Alright, Samco is happy. Marvelous. Let's go find... Yes, Andreja. No, Barrett. Sorry, you're Barrett. Hello, Barrett.
Okay. I admit... my famous personality wasn't so much help with this one.
And yeah, I've not seen Andreja, so... there we go. You're looking good too. Okay. As long as Sam and Andreja are fine, that's the important thing.
We need to talk locks and bolts. Lodge and the Eye are not secure.
Alright, you're not wrong. So, guessing keep them on the ship with me. That's got to be the right option, right? Then we're keeping them on the move. And if they do come and attack us, we can defend ourselves. That's got to be the best option.
Got the right of it.
The hunter, he probably found us because we're somewhere obvious. High populated area. Just like how the Starborn found you orbiting Neon the first time. But the fact that they're competing with us to find the artifacts means they can't get them without searching.
So we put the artifacts somewhere in the fringe, or on something that can slip from their grasp if they do another strike from the curtain.
Okay, so I feel like ship is the more sensible option here.
Fine idea. Starborn show up, you can burn helium in one spin of the grav drive to anywhere.
Here, keep the artifacts safe. I guess we'll meet back at the lodge after.
Okay, Noelle. We literally just discussed how the lodge wasn't safe anymore, but fine. And okay. We can now build a brand new little artifact container, McJibble. Gotcha. Here we go, right in the cockpit, we got ourselves a brand new screen. So, yeah, build this right here. And apparently, right, well, that was easier than I thought, though. Oh, right. If I'm carrying artifacts, they're going to be attacking me all over the place. And if I'm carrying this on my ship, they're going to be attacking the ship. Right. The ship is potentially now going to be under fire a whole lot more. So, okay, having lost a member, let's call it a part there. But, it would appear things just got a lot more serious than I was expecting. Like, you know, generally in Bethesda games, you do not lose your flipping companions. But, bare minimum, Andreja and Sam both survived, and that's important because I haven't decided which of them I want to date yet, so rest in peace, Sarah. You were a good navigator, dammit. And yes, indeed, next time we'll be nipping back down to the launch and coming up with a brand new plan of action because, yes, we have learnt a few important new tiny bits of information from the Hunter there, so hopefully we can start putting things together and formulating a plan to strike back because, yes, indeed, I would say we need to cocking avenge Sarah. So hopefully you join me next time for that. But in the meantime, I've been John. This has been Many a True Nerd. And this has been Starfield. Thank you very much, and goodbye.
Ah, we have got a gate key here, and then we have got... I've made a mistake! This is going to take all of my skill and cunning as a hunter to sort out... Die, you mooing bastards! Die! Die!
Go away. Nobody likes you.
That was a good idea till it wasn't.